EPAWA meteorologist Bobby Martins here with your outlook for the weekend, January 26th and 27th, 2019, for your Saturday. Expecting partly to mostly cloudy skies across much of the area. Further southeast, you might see more in the way of partly cloudy skies, but you have a weak disturbance in the region, and that disturbance may bring a few flurries to our interior areas out by State College and Williamsport, and you can see that here on the NAM. Just a few snow showers or light flurries that occur generally in the evening hours. And as we go progress through the evening, that lifts off to the north and east and pretty much dissipates before midnight. So that's not a big deal. Then we have another system coming in here for Sunday. This is actually a cold front in association with this low moving through the northern Great Lakes. And it's going to turn a little bit milder here on Sunday. Cold today, turning milder ahead of this front on Sunday. And I think you get up in the upper 30s to near 40, maybe even some lower 40s down here by Philadelphia. But generally a little bit milder as we have this cold ahead of the cold front with the winds turning to the southwest ahead of it. And as it moves through, you could have a few snow showers. Now, this will probably fall as snow where it does fall, even if the temperatures are marginal. It might not stick very well, but the upper levels are cold. It's a cold air, cold air advection. That's what I'm looking for. Cold air advection moving through. So at the same time, it'll be falling as snow from the clouds. Might not stick very well on the ground as it does reach the ground. The NAM has this as well to go forward from this point to later Sunday. You can see some snow showers out here during the afternoon in just west of our coverage area in central Pennsylvania. They're going to move eastward, and you can see that here. Here's a look at 4 p.m. and gets over to the eastern side of the state by 7, and it probably stops short of the Delaware River here, but it might sneak into northern New Jersey also. Just a few snow showers and flurries, not a big deal. At best, I think out here in central PA, where it is a little bit colder, you're expecting we could have up to a coating on the ground here in some spots with that. That's not a real big deal overall, so I wouldn't really worry about that. Our next system that we are going to worry about, though, is early next week, and this is being modeled very differently right now, and it has been for the last couple model cycles. Here's the GFS, and this is looking at Monday evening, and as you go through the overnight, it brings some light snow into the interior that's going to make its way eastward over into northeast PA, mainly north of 78, and it keeps it rain further south. Just light rain, though. This is a very light system and very weak, so it wouldn't be much in terms of snowfall. But this is all in association with this area, low pressure that cuts and does one of these numbers right up here, loops up in here into the lakes. But it maintains strength here. You can see it's a 996 millibar low that's sitting up here. So there is no coastal development or redevelopment on the GFS. There are other models, though, that are still in the other camp, and that are still in the other camp today. And basically, that low that moves up, and it moves up into southeastern Canada, a Canadian province here of Ontario, and it's still here. It's just very weak. It's 1,004 millibars. Big difference. Then we have another area low pressure is going to form right about here, and all this moisture that's associated with it. And it looks like it wants to take it up here, right? Just like this. So this is a little bit different of a scenario. This will get us a lot more snow if this occurred. And this was explained in yesterday's video. And I don't want to go through the whole big spiel about that again until we settle one way or the other. There's really nothing we can side against because they're really at an opposite ends of the spectrum. Do we develop a secondary low here or not? And that makes a big difference. Not only whether this develops, that's the first thing. Does this develop or not? You got a nice developing low here. That brings in a lot of extra precipitation that going right into later Tuesday and Tuesday night. If this does not develop, you have a GFS solution. If it does, you have something like this, or then you got to worry about track. Does it track a little bit further east and get more of the area into snow? Does it cut in here like the today's European model did and give the area in central Pennsylvania, northeast PA, a pretty good snowstorm? And areas further south and east just rain. We have to wait and see how that works out. A lot of different possibilities on the table yet, so we're not writing anything off. But I do like the idea of the coastal secondary forming. It's just a matter of where, like I just showed, either in or out, or maybe even further out. And what's going to make or break that is this incoming trough coming in behind it. Very cold temperatures associated with this trough as it moves in. And Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, through the end of our 7-day forecast period, very cold temperatures, highs stuck in the teens, single digits and teens in many areas, lows in the single digits and below zero single digits in some locations. So it's going to be very cold once we get to Wednesday. Wednesday is actually going to be a breezy day in the wake of this system moving out. You're going to have some windy conditions, and then we have the partly mostly sunny skies expected on all 3 days, Wednesday through Friday. It's going to be very cold. So when that trough settles in, it's going to depend on how fast that trough settles in. If it comes in a little bit faster and it's a little bit more progressive, then you have a system, even if it does form, that goes a little bit too far out to the east and misses everybody. If it's a little slower and maybe back here instead, then that system will be able to cut up like the European model had today. And if it's somewhere in between, you get a sizable snowstorm here for the interior. And when I say interior, maybe the northwest of I-95. We're going to check this out. I know drew a lot of lines there. Hopefully you're able to follow along. We're going to check this out over the weekend. Make sure we stay on top of it. And once we get rid of this split flow jet we have in the eastern Pacific, I think the models will start figuring these systems out a little bit better beyond 3 or 4 days. Because that's really the limit, reasonable limit of the models right now. And they just kind of suggest as something that they see as a signal. They don't really know what to do with it yet because there's so many different pieces of energy that are involved in that split flow jet in the eastern Pacific. And they're having a hard time resolving those differences. So we're going to go ahead and follow this over the weekend. Hopefully get some clarity and we go one way or the other. Again, there's a possibility that it is like a GFS solution, which is pretty much a cold front, warm front, and some snow, light snow in the interior, rain showers further south and east. And then we have the opposite end of the spectrum, which is a ramped up low, and that cuts inland and brings you an additional bit of rain or snow. And actually, in the interior, if this case were to work out, we get a pretty good snowfall, similar to the event we just had recently. So we're definitely going to stay on top of this weekend. Please follow along with social media for any updates. I'm EPAWA meteorologist Bobby Martrich. That is your outlook for the weekend, January 26th and 27th, 2019. Have a great Saturday and Sunday.